My name is Lucas Mistelis. I'm a professor of law at Queen Mary University of London and also the director of the School of International Arbitration, which is based at the Center for Commercial Law Studies. I'm also the author of the study guide in a regulation and infrastructure of international arbitration. International arbitration has emerged in the last 100 years as the principal method for the settlement of commercial disputes, and it's been used predominantly in commercial matters, but now arbitration has been used in a variety of matters, not just the classical commercial, that is, sale of goods, insurance, shipping, but now it's relevant for sports, is relevant even for investment disputes. In this course, in order to see how arbitration has evolved to the current important status it has acquired, we're going to be structuring the course in four sections. The first section will be looking at the regulation and infrastructure. That means we're going to be trying to define and delimit arbitration, and also we're going to be looking at the juridical nature of arbitration. How does arbitration fit into the legal system, if it at all fits in the legal system? As part of that section, we're also going to be looking at to how arbitration interacts with constitutional law and human rights. This is a rather modern topic. And also we're going to be looking at the interaction of arbitration tribunals or arbitration proceedings with the national court. We tend to say that arbitration is often under the supervision of national courts, and certainly there is a level of synergy and interaction in some cases, perhaps in about 10% of arbitration proceedings. The second section will be looking at the arbitration agreement. The arbitration agreement is the essential element for any arbitration to exist. Without the agreement of the parties to arbitrate, an arbitration cannot take place. So we need to have either a clear or an implied arbitration agreement. So in this section, we'll be looking at the various forms of arbitration, the formal requirements for an arbitration agreement to exist, the relevant applicable laws to establish the validity, both the formal and substantive validity of the arbitration agreement. And we're also going to be having a part of this section looking at guidelines for the drafting of arbitration agreements. The third section looks at the main actor from an arbitral perspective, and that is the arbitration tribunal. We'll be looking at how parties select and appoint arbitrators, what are the essential characteristics and features that one would like to see in arbitrators, their rights and duties and their powers. And we're also going to be looking particularly at the question of independence and impartiality, which is perhaps the most important duty of arbitrators. Finally, we'll be looking at the pathology as well, circumstances under which an arbitrator may be challenged or even removed. The final fourth section of this course will be looking at specialist arbitration and also arbitration involving states. So we're going to be looking at the role of the state as a party to arbitration proceedings, investment arbitrations, which are arbitrations under an investment treaty, typically a bilateral investment treaty or a multilateral treaty, like the Energy Charter Treaty or the Washington Convention of 1965. We're going to be looking at other specialist and mixed arbitrations, for example, the Iran US Claims Tribunal, or claims compensation commissions. And we're going to be looking also at sports disputes very briefly before concluding that section by looking at the modern topic of the online dispute resolution.